Governor Privilegeson, how do you see motivational speakers?
Oh, thank you very much, my son. How can you see why it's not there? First of all, let me say this. All the problems that this world is facing today, and the ones they have faced in the past, and the ones they are yet to face, they are all caused by motivational speakers. Ha! How can you be telling me that you are not a billionaire by what you have is by what you know? Do you know we were somewhere 2 days ago and one of them came? He was telling us that he's a motivational speaker by excellence. That he started taking care of himself when he was in his mother's womb. He left his parents' house when he was 6 months old. And he started taking care of his parents at age 2. He went further to say that I was sharing my business ideas with Bill Gates, Mark Zuckerberg, Otedola, when Dangote came and steal the idea. Well done, blackface of plantation boys. They are not stealing your ideas. This man did not end there. He told us that a week ago, he was called for a job worth 1.5 million naira monthly and other allowances. And he said, I rejected the call. Yes. We asked him, why did he reject the offer? He said the offer is an insult on his intellectual sagacity and a shame on his academic erudite. Do you know, he also told us that if we want to succeed in life, that we should read him. That he's an epitome and embodiment of success. Yes. That he didn't go around looking for success like Tony Elumelu, like Dele Mamadou. That success came to him.
What did you just say?
Do you know what this man said that bust my morale? He said he started visiting United States at age 7 to teach people how to succeed in life. And he became the first financial giant in his family at age 10. How now?
Dismiss.
This same man also told us that his first son became a professor at age 16. That he didn't pass through school. School went through him.
Hey!
The last thing he told us, I need to pull my shirt to say this. This same man told us that all the challenges, all the problems, all the corruption and confusion facing this world today, that the solution is in the book that he just wrote. But no money to produce the book. And he was telling us, my son, allow God to use you to contribute for the production of the book.
Wait, continue.
Do you know, they beat that man to coma. As I'm talking to you now, that man is in the hospital. can I go now? Which brother? Go and ask the man.
From the Privilegeson, how do you see the idea of sharing palliatives?
Oh, thank you very much, my son. How can you see why it's not there? The idea of sharing palliatives to the people by the government is a welcome development. And I think it's something that needs to continue. Whether COVID-19 go or stay, whether lockdown day or not, let them continue. Because overfeeding not the cause of us.
Very good.
Those in favor of this idea say aye. And those against say nay. The aye have it. Oh. Our lawmaker work. Thank God for COVID-19 that brought about the sharing of palliatives. If not, who does monkey banana? The only time they share money and food for people in Nigeria is during election and festive period. Make the sharing continue. If you not stop her, you now hear from me.
Wait, continue.
And those of you that have been receiving palliatives from the federal government and the state government, make una settle down the itamo. If you finish, make una ask for more. Na say supposed be.
No, guide this man go station.
And before you start eating those food, on your generator, because I know say they now fit give una food and light at the same time. Make una urgent to enjoy.
Jesus.
Money, they bank, they call. Also, they give people tribal mark for chest because of hunger. Simply because you are saving for your next of kin. Now your next of kin, go on show. Do you know, as I am under this sun now shouting and hustling, my next of kin is under AC, smoking shisha. Now that one, I won't leave my wealth for. How can you be saving money for your born generations and your present generations are dying of malnutrition and starvation? That is an error of omission. We go correct them. People are suffering in this country. You are busy burying money in your compound. Money na shit. Abi on your compound, na cemetery. Do you know if they should excavate the tomb in some people's compound today, you will be shocked of the millions and billions of dollars that you will find there. You see this earth that we are standing on? So many things are inside where we don't know. I leave you all with this question. I will see better.